Hey, what is up YouTube? This is the Merman Master coming at you guys from the Team Time Riders YouTube channel, and I'm super excited to bring you guys a brand new Venom Venominaga deck profile. Now, a lot of people have been asking for this deck profile for a very, very long time, and people have been looking for an update on how to run the deck in some of the new formats given the hit to Card of Demise. Now, I hope that I have provided an example for those Venom players who are looking to play a brand new version of this deck. So without further ado, let's get into the profile. Now, I wanna start by mentioning that this is very much a Protect the Castle deck. So we're starting things out with one copy of Venominaga, the Deity of Poisonous Snakes. Now this card is a fantastic card to get out because it comes to the field and is just a massive, just pain for your opponent to deal with. If they don't have a Kaiju to tribute over this, or they cannot destroy by battle, they're not getting this thing off the field. It's nearly impossible to do unless you do that, or you fusion summon it away, or do something of that nature. But even then, it's really difficult to deal with. It's basically just unaffected by everything and gains 500 attack. The monster that is necessary to bring it out, of course, is three copies of Venominon, the King of Poisonous Snakes. Very, very awesome card. However, pretty difficult to summon, so you want to run these to be able to get the card out. So what I'm going to do is just pop these over here, and we're going to continue on. Now for our Venom monsters, we've got three copies of Venom Serpent, three copies of Venom Snake, and one single copy of Venom Boa. All these monsters are pretty much vanillas, and for anyone looking to replace them with any kind of reptiles that you want, you can feel free to go ahead and do so. These reptiles are not really, they don't really plus you on your own, and you're not really running the Venom Swamps. So options like Iperia or Lion Alligator or different options like that are beneficial for people looking to get a little bit of flair and pizzazz into their Venom deck play. Do note, guys, I'm looking forward to uploading a reptile video coming out very, very soon. Next cards we've got in this deck, guys, are three copies of Lilith, Lady of Lament. She is one half of your Lilith Trap Trick combo. I bumped the number up from 2 to 3 because I wanted to see her more often. Basically, you use her to grab any of your normal trap cards out of the deck, and those trap cards will then help you set up your Venominaga combos. So that's going to do it for the monsters, guys. Around 10 reptiles, non-Venominaga. So I think around 14 monsters total in this deck. I'm going to discuss like different variants and things like that that you guys can run in place. But very, very good to know. Now, moving on to our spells. Of course, we've got to start things out with the one of Card of Demise. One of the best cards, and the single card that inspired me to build this deck. However, because the card is at one, we have to have a little bit of help for the card. So, bringing along the rear here, we've got two copies of Allure of Darkness and a single copy of Upstart Goblin. Now, you might ask why this ratio. Now, granted, you can replace Allure of Darkness with your Pot of Extravagance. Same thing with your Upstart Goblin. However, there's a particular reason why I wanted to have these cards in here. Now, Venoms are not a very consistent or fast deck by any stretch of the imagination. So you want to get as much card advantage as possible, given the types of plays that you are forced to make in the deck. Now, what's the big problem with Pot of Extravagance, you may ask? Well, when you activate Pot of Extravagance, while it's a great card and a natural plus two in a deck that does not really need or run an extra deck, guys, you are not really getting to the cards that you need. Because let's say you plus two into something like an Upstart or something like a Card of Demise. You cannot activate those cards and they are therefore dead in your hand. Set the cards on the field, do whatever you want. That's one less card in your hand that's useful. And given the fact that we're running a deck that is primarily based on particularly the Venom Snakes themselves, and rather than any kind of other reptiles that plus you, like Venominaga, or Iperia, or Yaoi, or anything like that, you know, this is very, very important. This is extra for important, especially for our next card, which has remained at 3 in the deck as well, guys. And that card is 3 copies of Pot of Duality. Now, Pot of Duality is a fantastic option for anyone looking to dig through their deck and not have to pay the insane amount of money that is required to pick up the new Pot of Prosperity. Pot of Prosperity might be beneficial or might be actually preferred by some players to dig through their deck for exactly the piece they need. However, Pot of Duality can serve that purpose just as well. And given the fact that you're doing most of your special summoning on your opponent's turn, it is a risk well worth taking. We have next 3 Snake Rains. Now, Snake Rain is one of those cards that is fantastic, and people say it's going to get banned in the future, and I'm inclined to agree. However, a lot of the recent Reptile support has not really had the meta-altering effect that Konami perhaps figured that it would have. I feel like particularly the Ogdo Addicts, which have come out, are great for generating a lot of advantage. However, they don't really do anything with it. Snake Rain in here is at 3 because you want to see this card and it is unsearchable, which is very, very unfortunate, guys. But Snake Rain being in here at 3 is a fantastic option for you to just dig through your deck, mill out reptiles, and improve your draws. Now, you might be asking, well, can it conflict with Allure of Darkness? And yes, it can. However, there are more often the opportunity that Allure is going to draw you into your Snake Ring. And the worst case scenario, guys, and the reason that I really, really do like Allure is because I finally found out how to mimic the discard to the graveyard effect the Card of Demise has. Now, Allure of Darkness will discard, assuming that you draw no dark monsters, will discard your entire hand to the graveyard. So let's say you draw into 2 Venom Snakes, right? You discard them to the graveyard and you get the same benefit as you would have with Card of Demise without the extra draw issues. Better yet, guys, if you draw into a Snake Rain and can just banish a dark reptile from your hand, you now have more milling that you can do. So I really do not think that this conflicts as much as people might consider. The last card I have in here, of course, is that Monster Reborn. Now, as you guys can notice, the spell lineup is staying pretty much the same because I didn't want to ruin or to mess with the style and play structure of this deck. And so I wanted to keep it as structured and as true to form as possible. Moving on to our traps, which is the last portion of this deck, guys. You guys who have seen the previous Venomenaga deck profiles have already seen these, guys. We've got 3 copies of Trap Trick. This is the main trap in your deck, and it digs for everything in your deck. And I'm going to tell you guys that is so, so important for all the different plays that you have in here. It is important for setting up your back row and for ensuring the correct process to trigger it. You can use it to grab a trap card that can be activated right when you have it. So if you draw into 2 Trap Tricks, you activate one on your opponent's turn, get a card to your back row, and then activate one on your turn to get another card. And it can help you get your play set started. Now, of course, it wouldn't be popular without the trifecta starting first with 2 copies of Foolish Burial. This is my own personal addition to the Venom deck strategy. And, kind of highlights the way that I like to build decks. 2 copies of Peaceful Burial basically is a searchable Foolish Burial that allows you to get Venomenon directly to graveyard so he can be revived by our next card here. That is Back to the Front. Back to the Front is a searchable revival and defense mode of your Venomenon or any other card in your graveyard. Really, really good card for all sorts of different plays. Moving on for our next traps, now that you have specialed your Venomenon to the field, you want to destroy it. So you've got either 2 copies of Torrential Tribute and 2 copies of Rise or Offering to the Snake Deity. Both of these cards serve the effect of destroying your Venomenon by card effect so that you can trigger Rise of the Snake Deity, which, when your Venomenon is destroyed by card effect, allows you to special summon Venomenaga, the deity of poisonous snakes, from your deck or hand. So basically, what you do is you send to the graveyard, you revive you destroy, and then you special summon. And all of this kind of balances together with your Lilith, Lady of Lament, allowing you to grab cards out of your deck, instantly set up your back rows, trigger all your stuff on your opponent's turns, and increase the consistency with the spells on yours. Last card I have in here is down from 3 copies to 1, Limit Reverse. This is kind of a controversial pick. You can still run, of course, 3 copies if you'd like. But, you know, people vary on that kind of aspect of things. But Limit Reverse is great because it is Revival and Destruction in one singular card. This Venomenon Engrave plus Limit Reverse plus Rise of the Snake Deity on your field equals a Venomenaga Deity of Poisonous Snake. So you get it out in less cards. The last card we have in here, of course, is still 2 copies of our Transmigration Prophecy. Shuffle 2 cards in either graveyard back to the deck. It's a nice trap disruption that can trigger to shuffle important cards that your opponent has in their graveyard that they're planning on using back to their deck, but most importantly allows you to bring a ditched Venomenaga back to your hand. Back to your deck so you can special summon it back. Now, this has been the deck profile. Of course, you guys feel free to run any extra deck monsters you would like or think that you want to run, and as well as any reptile monsters. But I really felt like I wanted to give you guys an update to the Venomenaga Venom deck. Do note, guys, if you're interested, I'm going to do a reptile showcase of all the different reptiles that you can run in a Venomenaga strategy. So look forward to that. And finally, I have a Venomenaga deck that I am currently working on with Crazy Tex that is going to feature the all new Venomenaga reptiles that have come out within the last year and a half. That deck is right here, actually, guys. So I want you to say down in the comments if you'd be interested in seeing that. It's a brand new list I built from the ground up, featuring almost completely different cards than this one, and is absolutely fantastic. It's been getting rave reviews at locals. And so if you guys are interested in seeing that, please let me know. I'd love to profile it. Still waiting on a couple cards in the mail, but once it's done, feel free to like the video, comment, subscribe, and let me know if you guys would like to see it. But with that being said, this has been the Mermail Master with the Team Time Riders YouTube channel. Thanks so much for watching, and looking forward to seeing you guys all later. Peace.